topic. So let us discuss about applications of BIOT SAVART law. Okay. So first we'll find magnetic field due to a stray current carrying conductor or wire. Okay?
Yes.
Right. Now, let us take that any current carrying wire is there.
Yes.
And we need to find magnetic field at this particular point P.
Yes.
Okay. And now suppose we are making, that you are joining them together, then it will become a finite length conductor. It will become a finite length conductor. And from this point, if you are joined here, R vector, so then it will become as some angle you take it as alpha, and this angle you take it as theta. Okay. You take this point as origin. And this is y direction plus, and this is minus. Okay. Now this element is carrying a current of I. And this direction, this is position vector R.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
At point P.
P.
Now in order to find, as we are knowing, that magnetic field due to BIOT-SAVART law is mu 0 by 4 pi I dl into R by magnitude of R cube.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
So what BIOT-SAVART law says? BIOT-SAVART law says that if we are in a position to find magnetic field due to a small current carrying element, and further if you will be integrating it between its limits, you will be able to find the magnetic field quantity. Okay. So magnetic field also follows the principle of superposition.
Okay.
Magnetic field also follows the, so this is also one of the difference. So difference was not there,
yes,
in electric field and magnetic field.
Yes.
What it was there, both the laws follow superposition principle.
Yes.
Okay? Right. So now in order to find this, let us suppose that a small element.
Yes, sir.
Let us take into consideration a small element dx.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And now this element you take as at some angle theta. At some angle theta. Okay. And this is making an angle d theta. This is d theta. So this angle is d theta. Right? Okay. So now what it is there? This is small element dl actually. This is dl. This is small current carrying element. Its width is dl. Okay. So idl,
yes,
you can say it is dl. Right. Now, what you do? You draw a perpendicular from here, from this point, you draw a perpendicular here. Okay. So this perpendicular, this distance is x. Take that, this distance is x. Okay. Now if this distance is x, then this particular element will be x d theta. X d theta.
Okay.
Why? Because you are knowing that suppose if you are going for in a circle and this is the radius. So this arc length can be formed if this is the angle theta. So this angle arc length is r theta.
Yes, sir.
So this arc length is one arc theta. So we can take it as almost all as arc length type.
Yeah.
It's
x theta.
This width will be x theta. Okay. Right. Now, so this will be there.
Yes.
And now this dl. So this dl will be finding. How we are going to find? So by utilizing this one, if suppose this angle is theta, so we are knowing that cos theta is equal to b by h,
yes, sir.
Means base by
hypotenuse.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Base by hypotenuse. So that base is this one x d theta, so we can write x d theta by hypotenuse is dl.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so from here what we are finding, dl is equal to x d theta by cos theta.
So hypotenuse is
dl. DL is the hypotenuse. This is the perpendicular.
Okay, okay.
This is the perpendicular.
Okay.
Okay.
What
is perpendicular? And what it? Okay. And now this angle is theta.
Yes.
This angle you will take it as theta. So in terms of theta, cos theta is equal to base by hypotenuse. So this is base and this is hypotenuse. So x is theta by dl. So what you are getting? X. Second theta, d theta. So dl, what we are getting? X, second theta, d theta.
For the small triangle.
For a small, this dl. Dl we need to find?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now, x. So x will be what? Now x. So x will be r?
R by d.
Okay. So it is, you can say, x or you can say r by x,
yes,
is equal to what? Cos theta?
Cos theta.
Cos theta. So x will be r by cos theta, which is giving you r
yes,
second theta. So x can also be written in terms of r as r second theta. Yes or no?
Yes.
So x we can write it as r second theta. Where r is a vector.
Yes.
So r second theta. Can you write like this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If we can write like this, then further we will place the value for this small current carrying elements in this BIOT-SAVART law. So dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi and I will be as it is. dl, can we write it as x second theta d theta?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this one will be x second theta d theta and r. R what will be writing? R second theta. So here we will be writing
x by theta.
Sorry. R is here x only.
Yes.
R is here x.
Okay, okay.
R is here x. Okay. So x. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Into x.
Sir.
Divided by.
R will cancel no sir. We just write r square.
Now we are finding for a small current carrying element where distance is x. Where distance is x. Okay. So for this small current carrying element where the distance is not r, distance is x. We will be replacing the values. Then we will cancel. Whatever it will be getting cancelled, we will cancel. Okay. So x second theta into x and divided by again here x cube only.
Yes sir.
X cube only. Okay. Right. So it will be mu 0 by 4 pi dB. Now mu 0 I let us write. Here it has become x square. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Second theta, d theta. And it has become here?
X cube.
X cube. Okay. Now we will put the value of x here. That r second theta there. Okay. So you can cancel this x like this also we can cancel.
Yes, sir.
Right? Okay, we will be able to cancel. But let us see, we will cancel it all together at one time. By x cube. All together at one time. Now we will be placing this value. So mu 0 I by 4 pi into. So x square will be r square second square theta. So r square. Second square theta into second theta. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Divided by R cube, second cube theta.
Yes. Yes or no?
Okay. So this R square will cancel it as R, and this second cube theta will get completely cancelled. This d theta is there.
Yes, sir.
I have forgotten this one. Sorry. So this d theta will be there. Okay. So d theta is there now. So this is R. So what value we are getting? dv is equal to mu 0 I by 4 pi R d theta. Mu 0 I by 4 pi R d theta. Now what we see here? In this case, okay, due to this small current carrying element, now we will be having magnetic field in two directions. In two directions. One is perpendicular direction also, and another one is parallel. Okay, one will be in perpendicular direction. Okay, so if suppose you are taking it as parallel, if suppose you are taking it as parallel component, so dv parallel component and perpendicular to the board, then to the board if I am writing in this way, so this one will become perpendicular component. Yes or no? So our resultant magnetic field, suppose if you will be saying, then this one will become dv, and if you are taking it as angle theta.
Yes, sir.
Okay? Right or?
Right.
Okay. So now this dv perpendicular, so what we will be writing? We will be writing as dv sin theta. Okay, sorry, dv cos theta. This perpendicular component, this one will be writing as dv cos theta.
Okay.
And parallel component, dv sin theta. Okay, wherever this angle is there, that part, that side, always it is cos theta. Okay, wherever you are putting that angle, so that side it will be cos theta, another side it will be sin theta. So dv parallel is equal to dv sin theta. Understood this one?
Yes.
Right. So now we will be able to find perpendicular component separately, we will be able to find parallel component separately. Okay? So now we will be finding perpendicular component and parallel component. So whether this side you have put it down?
Yes.
Okay. Right. So no problem. Just listen and then you note it down completely. Okay. Here we will be writing. Now let us find first perpendicular component of magnetic field. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
This side for all.
So what will be writing here? Like, suppose if I am writing B perpendicular component there, magnetic field, then it will be dB perpendicular.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes.
dB perpendicular and integration. So integration will be from where to where? From negative of B to positive of alpha, angle will be correct. So it is negative beta at alpha.
Yes
or no? Okay. So now B perpendicular magnetic field we are finding. So dB perpendicular is what? dB
cos theta.
Cos theta. Okay. So dB is what? This one mu 0 I 4 pi r d theta. Okay. So we will be writing dB cos theta.
Yes, sir.
dB cos theta. Then minus beta to alpha.
D theta.
dB is this one?
D theta.
Mu 0 I by 4 pi r. This d theta will come from here.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. And cos theta d theta. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So mu 0 I by 4 pi r will become constant. Okay, so this will come outside. So mu 0 I by 4 pi r. And cos theta d theta, what will be the integration? Sin theta. Okay? So sin theta. And
minus
beta and
alpha.
Okay? Right. So this definite integral, when you are solving, so it will become minus, sorry, mu 0 I by 4 pi r. And this sin theta means sin alpha first?
Sin alpha minus sin beta.
sin alpha
plus
minus sin
minus beta.
So sin minus beta is equal to minus sin beta. So minus minus will make it plus. So it will be mu 0 I by 4 pi r sin alpha
plus sin beta.
Sin beta.
Yes.
So that perpendicular component of magnetic field we found this one.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So by putting the different values of alpha and beta, we will be able to get the magnetic field. Okay. Let us find parallel.